The Forbidden City presents its past and present. The history of the Forbidden City stimulates people to fantasize the royal family's lives with the Great Red Walls. Was it a wonderland that led to prosperous life or a prison that took a freedom away? The history would eventually fade away, but the ancient architecture remains. It is the witness that can tell us the stories. There are more than 1,000 large or small buildings in the Forbidden City with different styles and functions. Among them, the most majestic, spectacular, and core buildings are the three main halls, namely the Hall of Supreme Harmony, the Hall of Central Harmony, and the Hall of Preserving Harmony, which are located in the outer court of the Forbidden City. Since the completion of the three major halls, they have been damaged by many natural and man-made disasters, then reconstructed and preserved by successive emperors. The main body of the building is covered with the golden glazed tiles, and architecture of roofs vary depending on the rank of inhabitant. The roof of the emperor's room, called Wudian, had 5 ridges and 4 slopes. In the feudal society, Wudian was a symbol of ruling classes, such as the imperial power and the divine power. It was mostly used in palaces, altar temples, important gate towers, and other senior buildings. Other government buildings and common people's houses were not allowed. In addition, if you observe carefully, you will find a variety of odd-looking animal figures standing on the corners of the roofs. The ancient Chinese people were using these mythical figures to decorate the roofs, and secondly, they believed fish-tailed animals as symbol of water might carry the power of water to prevent the fire, since the halls and palaces in the Forbidden City were made of wood. Smart idea, isn't it? And thirdly, numbers had also carried some superstition meanings. Chinese people in the past honored odd numbers, which were 9, 7, 5, 3, and 1. That's why you will see these fish-tailed animal figures varying from 9 to 7, 5, or 3. The 9 fish-tailed animals, together with the leading one, vary on the phoenix back and hang shu. The monkey-like one in the very end had formed a superb composition that advocated the power and the dignity of the royals, which could only be seen on the roof of the Hall of Supreme Harmony, and you will become an expert by yourselves now. Check how many fish-tailed ones on the other two halls, and you will be amazed by this strict hierarchy system in the past. The Hall of Supreme Harmony was used to hold major ceremonies, such as emperor's accessions to the throne, emperor's wedding, expedition, special festivals, and etc. Here, the emperor would receive the congratulations of civil and military officials and hold a banquet for the princes and ministers. At that time, when the emperor came to the Gate of Supreme Harmony, or the Hall of Supreme Harmony, the civil and military officials would kneel down and kowtow 3 times, shouting long life the emperor. The scene was extremely impressive. There is a white platform in front of the Hall of Supreme Harmony. The symbol of imperial power, the sundial and the jialiang, were displayed on the platform. Though 600 years have passed, it is as if the glory of the Forbidden City reappears when the sun rises again. To the east and the west of the platform, there is an auspicious bronze turtle and a bronze crane respectively. They are placed here to symbolize the longevity of the country. When grand ceremonies were held in the Hall of Supreme Harmony, people would light incense in the incense burners that were set along the terraces. The smoke curled around the platform and floated around the 3 halls, creating a mysterious atmosphere. Under the Hall of Supreme Harmony is a 3-story marble carved base surrounded by railings, under which are stone carved dragon heads for draining water. During the rainy season, the dragon will appear to be spitting water upon the Hall of Supreme Harmony Square. Before holding ceremonies in the Hall of Supreme Harmony, the emperor would rest in the Hall of Central Harmony, where deacon officers would come to worship him. The day before the emperor made offerings to the gods of heaven and the earth, he would read the rites in the Hall of Central Harmony. Seeds and farm tools would also be kept there, which the emperor would inspect before they were put to use. The Hall of Preserving Harmony, located behind the Hall of Central Harmony, was used differently in the Ming and Qing dynasties. For example, during the Ming dynasty, the emperor would often change clothes there before a ceremony. However, the hall would be used in entertaining princes and ministers on special occasions, such as the New Year's festival during the Qing dynasty, as well holding the annual final imperial examination. The final imperial examination, which was abolished after more than 1,000 years of practice alongside the feudal imperial examination system, was held for the last time in the Hall of Preserving Harmony. When we look back the history of our country, the three majestic and solemn main halls paint a picture of the dignity and the magnificence of the emperors. It is the survival of the buildings, as well as some culture-like grand music passed down to future generations. That reminds us how different our world used to be.